without too many losses. I'm a little surprised by that. I think if Joyo had focused fire on just the command center, I think he could have taken it down before the glides came back to reinforce, and that might come back to haunt him here in this game, letting Boxer continue to have the economic advantage. Joyo actually has produced an Arbiter also. Interesting, so going for a lot of tech off of basically two bases, although he does have two gas, it's basically two normal bases, or maybe two and a half bases, but his main's going to be mined out soon. He still hasn't picked up that last expansion on the map there. And after that, all expansions will be used up, by the way. This map is just so, so low in resources. I really haven't seen any map like outside of Bloodbath that's so short of resources as this map is. So Joyo going for all sorts of tech here, but I don't know if he's going to be able to support that, especially because this map's going to be mined out in about 10 minutes or so if this game lasts any longer. I don't know if it was a wise idea for him to go for Arbiters also. Perhaps he's thinking about a recall inside of Boxer's main to pick off the carriers, pick off the factories rather, but I think going for straight carriers would have been a better idea. He also has two shuttles here, so now this hybrid force here of everything, basically Arbiters, carriers, and ground forces is now going to try and assault at the left side once again. Carriers in front picking off the turrets, and I believe that's something like four carriers there, so but there are a number of glides on the low ground, but these Dragoons are actually going to outrange the glides, so they can't stay near the mineral patches to be able to fight here. The glides are going to have problems against these Dragoons, and once again, I'm surprised the Boxer didn't go for any siege tanks here. I think siege tanks would have helped greatly in defending these bases. Just a couple of siege tanks, even on low ground, would have been able to do fine, and now Boxer's going to lose all these lose mining at this base here because of the Dragoons alone, and Boxer's just unable to do anything with glides shooting upwards against ranged Dragoons. You just can't do anything about that. That's just not a winning battle. But Boxer does have a ton of glides here. Certainly, he can kill the interceptors of the carriers, so the Dragoons are limited to doing damage here on the side. So a really interesting stalemate here at the Western expansion. But Joyo is catching his new expansion finally at the right side. Definitely a low econ game for both players, though. A low econ late game, basically. That's something you don't see every day. Boxer with his first tank of the game, finally. I feel that he would have benefited from tanks earlier so far, but I guess he just felt like he wanted to go for a killing blow with Goliaths. But now realizing that with enough ground forces, he can't do much. Oh, and his dropships are getting caught in the middle here by the carriers. That's terrible for Boxer. He might have lost two of his dropships there, hopefully not full of units, or else he's going to be in even worse trouble. Boxer with, I think, six carriers now. I think he can just range that refinery and pick it off. So he's going to be able to stop mining completely at this base. And Boxer is going to lose some of these stray glides if he moves too close to the mineral patches and to that ledge. I won't be surprised if Joyo gets some High Templar there. Boxer, meanwhile, dropping on the lower right side. Nice work there. Losing a couple of his forces, though. He will be able to pick it off. I think he lost another dropship, though. So good work by Boxer going for a surprise attack there and picking off everything over there. I think Joyo is going to try to retrieve that that expansion with his carriers. I think these carriers are probably going to have success against this because there just aren't that many Goliaths over there. And I think equal numbers of carriers to Goliaths, especially using the ridges, of course, Joyo is going to win that battle. Meanwhile, Boxer needs to get that tank over there. He needs to get that tank sieged up in that third base of his, or else he's just going to be in huge trouble. He's having to build another barracks, too. And Joyo, what are you doing? Joyo walking into the glides. That's poor micro. Very poor carrier micro. This, you can definitely tell this is the early days of StarCraft. I don't think there would be such poor micro nowadays when Protoss go for carriers. But he has managed to pick off the Goliaths at the loss of, I believe, at the cost of one Arbiter. I feel like that was unnecessary, bringing the Arbiter up even. Perhaps he just wanted Boxer to have to use a couple of scans. But I think that was unneeded there. He could have just attacked from the ridges and pulled back, attacked from ridges and pulled back, etc. Now he's actually gotten a couple of shuttles, and he's actually got some Zealots into Boxer's main. And wow, those Dragoons are hidden underneath that little arch. Boxer is going to know this is here, though, because of the SCV, and Boxer is unloading a huge force of Goliaths to take care of this. He will be able to take care of this drop here. There's pretty much nothing that those forces are going to do. They're just completely stranded. Here comes Boxer with all of his Goliaths to clean up that Dragoon force here. Yeah, those couple of Zealots and Dragoons are just not going to do it. Boxer with some nice micro there, not allowing any of those speed lots to get any shots on him. Meanwhile, though, Joyo going for an attack at the main here with his carriers, and I believe that's another drop here with Dragoons in the main base of Boxer, and Boxer may not have enough to take off this, to win this battle here, and he's going to lose his main, and that's a lot of Dragoons. I think that's eight Dragoons. I think that was actually a recall. It had to have been a recall. So Joyo actually doing that on purpose, perhaps, doing the 1-2 punch, dropping some units, and goading, luring Boxer's glides to the right, meanwhile bringing his carriers directly into Boxer's main. And oh man, Boxer's main is completely open to attack right now. Boxer has lost the ground battle and the air battle. Well, he basically can't win against these carriers, and he can't win against these dragoons. And Boxer is in just absolutely huge trouble. He's got a couple of glides left on the right side, but he's not going to be able to hold against so many forces. He loses his tank. He's going to lose these factories now. And Boxer in absolute huge trouble. His main base completely breached. He's going to have to rely on what's coming out of the factories. And frankly, that is not going to be enough. I think Joey had to have done a recall there, but I didn't see the Arbiter. Maybe he just did two drops. Maybe he did one drop, and then he ferried more units. I think what he did actually was he ferried units all the way to the middle and to the gap over there, right, very close to Boxer's base. And then he did two quick drops in succession to get all the forces into Boxer's main. Meanwhile, Boxer's still trying to pick off whatever is there with a couple of Goliaths. Jojo can just focus on the factories, though, after these are down. He just needs to focus fire on the Goliaths, and then afterwards the factories. There goes the last of Boxer's forces in his main. Boxer now losing all of his factories at a very quick rate here. And Boxer is... this is pretty much... I think most players would GG at this point. Even though Boxer does have two more bases, he doesn't have any production there. I'm wondering if he's building factories there at a desperate rate to try to perhaps survive. And looks like he's actually reinforcing this base with probably what was there from the upper right. Actually managing to pick off a carrier here. Two carriers down by Boxer. Down by Boxer. Another carrier going down. So managing to pick off all the carriers. That was absolutely crucial there. But still enough Dragoons to pick off this force. But Jojo not microing his carriers away from those Goliaths. Gets all of them, most of them picked off. Only two remaining for him now. Jojo needs to continue building forces and just build all ground forces even. Covert Ops was actually up for Boxer. I don't know if you guys see that. He's actually was going for Ghosts. Obviously, he can't go for Ghosts anymore. The Mineral only is completely mined out for Boxer. Boxer only relying on one base here. He's ferrying more units from the upper left, though. I think this is whatever's remaining. You can see in Boxer's face, he knows he's in huge trouble. He's still getting pinned in, and once again, he cannot win the ground battle. Is he going to win this ground battle? It's going to be very close here. Only one tank and two Goliaths alive. But Jojo not focusing fire here. Needs to get the Zealot to kill his tank. Jojo a terrible micro here, I have to say. This is very, very poor micro. He's actually lost all of his forces, but he's actually killed all of Boxer's forces, rather. But only with two Zealots alive and one carrier. So poor micro by Jojo. And Boxer may be able to hold his main base just barely from reinforcements, but I just don't know if Boxer has any more factories in this game. If he has no factories, he can't do anything. Jojo just needs to ferry those units across from his main base, and he'll be able to take it down. But Boxer has managed to hold his main. His main is still alive, even though he has no factories. I just wonder where he made those units. It has to be at the upper left. But no, the upper left is actually doesn't have any factories. So I have no idea where Boxer came up with those units. He just conjured them out of thin air. But Jojo now coming with another drop at Boxer's one remaining base with any minerals. He's dropping, looks like, all speed lots here. And one Dragoon and speed lots. I think Boxer has one mobile force left at his main base, and that is it. Afterwards, he's going to be completely mined out. Jojo probably can storm those SCVs also right now and get away with it. But Boxer actually using that one tank he has left very well, cliffing the expansion to the right there that Jojo's picking up. And Jojo's got to be running out of resources also. That is.